Hello, friend. Welcome back to my calculator, which I have been showing. This is the second part. So this calculator, as I showed you, when you run, I have written the codes for the total. You can see the total here. But I want to have a reverse format in three ways. So when I make this two, I have to get answer over here. And when I have this two, I should have answer over here. But now there is no code written, so you can see nothing is changing here apart only just from this. So let's start with the codes. And this is my user form. So if you want, I can change the name into total underscore calc. So let me do the second code. So the first code was for this one, which we had called totals. So the second code is for the, I'll be making for this one. So the code will be like, if this multiplied by this, you get the answer of total. So this divided by this will give you a total over here. So this divided by this will give you a total here. So it's a reverse order. So let's do that. So what I have to do is go here and double click this. So now the easy way I just showed you, we have to select the values. So first we will be doing is the answer we want in over here. So we will be copying this, Control C, copy. Equals to. So copy this, Control C. Divided by. So this should be divided by. This is per month. Equal to this divided by this area. So copy this, Control C. So let's go and check this now. So if you have 1000 multiplied by 2, you get 2000. So if you want to have, if you have 20,000, you're getting the answer. So you're getting the reverse form, but here you're not getting answer. You have to write a code for here. So any number, if you can, if you want to keep on checking, you can just see other things are changing. So now let's write a code for the this one here. So relation unit is going to be like this amount. So here it will be like this amount divided by this amount, you will get the relation unit. This divided by this, you will get the answer here. So for that, you have to go to relation unit, double click this. And the answer you want over here. So click this. Control C. Equals to. Go over here, copy this, see this, copy this, Control C. First, take space on that, space. And this, copy this, Control C, and divide by this space. So now let's go and check this. So I will give the first part 24,000, and if it is 10. And now if I make this into 12, so you can see it's working here. And if I make changes over here, so it's working in the 3 dimension. So unless and until there is some changes, so it's working in the 3 dimension. Now if I want to change this again into 12, so you can see it's working in 3 dimension rows. So all our codes are working fine. So we have to add some more buttons, clear the screen and exit. So we have space over here. So let's do that also. We're closing this. So now we have to go to a command button. This is a command button. And I'm going to type this into. Here, let's call screen. Copy this and paste it over here. And make this a boulder. Later, if you want to change, if you can change the color also. And again copy this, control C and control V, paste this here and make this into exit. Don't exit, so it will be exitor. Copy this caption and change this into here. We can have a caption, and if you want, you can change this color into. So now we have to write a code for this. So clear screen code will be like, you should know the name is called total calc. So again, it's total underscore calc. So when you go to clear screen, total C, be careful with the spellings. Dot unload. So no space, unload the object and copy this, control C, control V, dot show. So you clear and we'll show it again. So if you want to see this, so it's going to clear the screen. Now to exit, we need to write a command, and when you double click on this, so the same thing, copy and paste this name of the form dot hide, dot hide. So we have a format hide. So this is the exiter button, so it's an exiter. So automatically hide, but now I'm having this, so it's coming here. So if you want, you can have some other things over here in another calculator. You can have as many things instead of dragging too many things down. So, and now I want to, if you want to have some commas or something, because the screen is going to be too lengthy, you can do that also. So you can see duration. Let me copy this. So if you want to see this, this is for duration. Okay, don't click that. Equals to format, open parenthesis. I can copy duration, comma. Double quotes, close this. And check this now. So if you have things, you can see you can hit commas, and if you want the same thing over here also, we can do the same again. So this is called total. So copy this. Is this again equals to format is total, comma, double quotes, 1, 2, 3. Close the double quotes. And now you can check again. And this is normal what we can have, so you can see you can get the commas. So if you want to, you can just broad the screen also. Whatever you have to do is here only. Just widen this. So it's more clear. And so I hope you find this video useful, and I would like to request you to subscribe the button, and thanks for watching this.